Hi everyone, merhaba, this is Ayşenur Altan. Welcome to Turkish Food Recipes. In this episode, we are making Turkish bazlama bread. It is similar to pita, has milk in the dough, and is softer in texture. Goes well with a Turkish breakfast or dinner any time of the day, or make a sandwich with it. With some good tips, it is easier to make than you think. Let's get started. I'm gonna begin by adding half cup of lukewarm water to my mixing bowl. To that, add 1 tablespoon dry yeast and 1 tablespoon sugar. I'm gonna wait until it is activated and foamy, as you can see, about 5 minutes. And I added 1 cup lukewarm milk. And first, I'm gonna add 3.5 cups of all-purpose flour to it, and 1 teaspoon salt, and begin to mix. It's kind of a simple yeast dough with milk. You can also make this using mineral water. We call it soda in Turkish. Add more flour if needed, and knead for at least 5 minutes until you have a nice little bit sticky dough. And now I'm going to make a ball and then let it rise until it is doubled. My dough is doubled. I'm gonna show you in a moment. Here we go, and I sprinkled some flour onto the cutting board, and now I'm going to portion them. For the size, you can make it smaller or bigger if you don't want to spend too much time on cooking on stovetop. Or you can make it smaller and use 2 pans and bake them together to make it easier and faster. I just portioned to a 6 serving size. Sprinkle some flour on top and bottom, make sure it doesn't stick. And now I'm going to roll them out with a rolling pin. You can also use your hands to make it. Both are okay. When you roll the dough with your hands, it seems that it keeps the air pockets inside better when you are using a rolling pin. Of course, you get some of the air out, but that's okay. Here's the first one. It is about, the thickness is about a 0.5 centimeter, and the thickness is important actually. It shouldn't be very thinly. It will still be nice, but somewhat crunchy rather than a soft bread. If you make it thicker, it takes more time to cook. It's okay, but you might not get an air packet inside to make the bread separate. Of course, don't make it bigger than your pan, otherwise it won't fit. And use a damp cloth to cover them to prevent them drying out. Here I wanted to try it to roll it with my hand. And this is the last one. I wanted to damp the cloth a little more, and I waited about 15 to 20 minutes to let them rise again a little bit. The second rise is very important, don't skip it, to make it a soft bread. And here I sprinkled some semolina It gives a texture on the outer skin of our breads and also prevents using too much flour. You can also use cornmeal, a coarse one, or whole wheat if you can find, or just skip this step. Since my kitchen was not that hot, it took about a half an hour to until I see them rise again. My pan is preheated. The heat is on a medium high and I close a lid on top so I can make a cozy, hot, warm pan inside for my bread, bazlama. And here you can see some bubbles. After you see them, just turn it over. As you can see, we still don't have any colors on the side, but we want to partially cook, you know, and turn it over alternately. And this way, without, you know, overcooking one side, turn it over every 20 to 30 seconds. And this way, we are trying to form an air packet inside, and you get this result. It's really fun to make. Don't be sorry if you don't get this result on first time. After, you know, cooking one or two times or three times, you will get used to it. It will still be delicious if you don't get an air packet, but this way it really looks nice and you can use as a sandwich bread also. And after you get the packet opened all the way up, you can turn it over again and then cook until it is lightly colored. Don't overcook again to keep it soft, otherwise they dry out. Here I turn on the heat a little more, so to help the steam rise again. So you can, you might need to, you know, play with the heat from time to time to help it cook. Usually it takes about 5 minutes to cook one. Each one you can use, work with the two pans and make it shorter the cooking time. With a little bit faster, let me show you one more time how I cook it. Here I see the bubbles and turn it over. The other side is still white, no colors yet. I have medium high heat. And now I begin to see some bubbles again. Turn it over and turn it over again. If you look at carefully, you will see some bubbles happening. And I close the lid again. With the warm environment, now I see the air packet coming now. Yes, I waited a little more. Some people don't use lid when cooking, but I really prefer this way. I tried and it worked better, easier. And I turn it over again and see it still rises. Sometimes you can see the bread, the dough can break and steam can come out. You can close that with your spatula to help it rise again. And it's done. Make sure you cover the cooked bazlamas with another lid or a clean kitchen towel so they don't dry out and stay warm and soft. Let me show you one after I bake all of them. As you can see, it's very soft, goes so well with Turkish breakfast, our favorite, like you can make it on weekends. And here is a nice packet, you can make sandwich. As I said, don't feel bad if you don't get the air packet. Sometimes even I don't get them. You have to be careful with the turning, playing with the heat and turning it over before it dries out again. So I hope you try and like the recipe. Let me know. You can share your photos with me from my Instagram account, Turkish Food Recipes. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you in another delicious Turkish food recipes and vlogs. Afiyet olsun.